Hey guys, it is Josh alongside Jacob and Brock. We're standing by in Lehi, Utah at the Baird Manor. It's Halloween, right? It's Halloween season. We're here to kind of get a behind the scenes look and a sneak peek at some of the shows that the Baird Manor is going to be showing this Halloween season. So,
let's get to it.
Let's do this.
Happy Halloween from Rebel One.
We're here at your Baird Manor. And you do this every year.
Yep.
How long have you been doing it?
About 20 years.
20 years?
Yeah.
Okay. At this location?
Not at this location. We actually started at my dad's house. I have a little dinky apartment. It would be much of it. So we actually did it at my dad's house for probably 10 years.
Okay.
And then 2020 is when we did it officially here. So with COVID, it was kind of a nice clean break to start moving here.
Oh, yeah. That's a great break. So, how long did it take you to set all this up this year?
Oh man, we started in August.
In August? You've been doing this since August?
And yeah, we don't do it continually, but we got the jack-o'-lanterns out. We have nearly 300 jack-o'-lanterns.
300?
So we got those out in August.
That's incredible.
In fact, some of our projections, we were filming the projections and there were fireworks going off in the background.
So you were filming
even a little before August.
So what kind of projections were you filming?
Let's see, what were we filming that time? It was Halloween.
Well, and sorry, let me interrupt. Let's introduce these guys. This is your team.
Yes.
All right, go
Stay
ahead.
Chance.
What's your name?
Jordan.
Jordan, all right. And?
Cody.
Cody.
Tanner.
And Tanner, okay. And they're all your sons?
Yep.
Okay.
Stagehands, professional haunters.
Well done, guys. And you guys do this every year?
Yep.
That is awesome. Do you have any real pumpkins that you'll have?
Yeah, we haven't selected them yet, but we go to...
Yeah, because, I mean, pumpkin season's just starting.
The bigger the better. The bigger pumpkins we can get.
You can get the gigantic ones?
If I can find them. I've always wanted to do the giant jack-o'-lanterns, but I don't have the patience.
You ever thought about growing them?
Yeah, that's the way I mean. I've tried to grow some. And
I'm with you. It takes a lot of work. Well, this is pretty neat. So we've got a projection on a jack-o'-lantern here. It's a face, but this is controlled by... I was back there. And it has a camera that reads your facial expressions and as you speak into a mic.
Yep. Yeah, so it's done with the Adobe Character Animator. So you create a face, a puppet,
that's
rigged to move all the different ways that you want to.
Uh-huh.
And then through the software, it has a camera that can look at your face. It can look at head movement, eye movement, eyebrows, and of course mouth movement too. So it's interesting.
Now, I've never been here before. Is that new this year or is it...
It's new this year. We've done some variations on it in the past with different interactive digital effects, but this guy's new.
Okay.
It's a new addition to the Baird Manor.
Well, let me ask you your favorite thing here that you've set up so far.
The backyard is definitely this.
We can go into years past, too.
And I probably say that every year with whatever's name.
Okay.
So this year, it's this one.
It's
last year, we had a character named the Candleman. You're familiar with some Disney lore.
Okay.
So there was a concept character done by Raleigh Crump, one of the original Imagineers, of this Candleman figure that's just dripping with wax. And it was just a concept character that never got put into any show or any ride at Disneyland.
Okay.
And so we made a 6-7 foot tall physical Candleman prop, and then we did digital overlay augmented reality with wax dripping down in the flames. And so we had that. That was my favorite last year because it was a little throwback to
That's so cool. And now Raleigh Crump, did he work on Haunted Mansion?
It's a Haunted Mansion, Small World. So if you see a lot of the original concept art, a lot of it's Raleigh Crump.
Okay.
And Candleman. You know, we brought his creation to life. And in his words, amazing. So Disney Imagination.
Raleigh,
family friendly.
From what I've seen about Raleigh, he's a little rough around the edges. So that sounds about right on par with him. Okay. So how many visitors do you get every year?
Oh boy.
Roughly.
It's in the hundreds.
Okay.
Most people come just for the front show because they can do it in their cars. Especially during COVID, that's kind of when we got started and we weren't sure if trick-or-treating was going to be a thing.
Uh-huh.
So having the projection mapping on the front of the house, people could just drive up to their cars and they could watch the show. And so we get, I have no idea how many people we get in the front. We'll have lines of cars out onto the main street here. We did have the cops call us the traffic issues last year before. So
well, how do you deal with that?
Encouraging people to park out on this street instead, and we actually have a different digital puppet that we're having kind of an intro for people saying, you know, stay out of our neighbors' driveways, turn off your headlights. So
okay, and so we can invite people here, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in order to get here, just plug in Baird Manor into Google Maps, it'll bring you right here.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. It's been a pleasure getting to know you and the boys, and I'm amazed at all the hard work. And it just seems to keep growing every year.
Yeah, it's mostly them this year.
Well, that's awesome. Do you guys have anything that's your favorite? The scarecrow this year. We're talking scarecrow.
It helped build it. The bunker is made of foam. And PVC. Body.
Foam and PVC.
So you guys basically.
Yeah.
That's incredible. Well, thank you. Thank you for having us.
Thanks. Thanks for coming.
Hello there, Marianne. Wowza, wowza. Hubba, hubba. Oh yeah. Too bad she's not here.
Happy Halloween, everybody. It's a mutant house. Just kidding.
It's a demon.
Welcome, visitors, to our mansion. We do hope you enjoy your stay. Before you can begin to know the story of Baird Manor, I must first introduce you to its inhabitants. Here before you are the occupants of Baird Manor. Each has their own story, and each one more tragic than the last. Watch as their withered souls trapped within these portraits begin to emerge. Now that you've been introduced to the family, it's time you met the rest of our happy haunts.
Thank you.
thank you for visiting our manor. Please come again. And maybe next time, you won't leave.
To let me know, should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know,
should I stay or should I go?
Will, are you there? Will!
Nothing. What is wrong with my boy?
I don't understand. However, what? She was too.
It's like it's reaching into our kidneys. Anyone knows how to destroy this thing. It's Will.
Oh my God.
Don't you think it's weird how we only seem to hang out when the world's about to end?
It's not like it was before. It's grown.
It's Judgment Day. Which is why we need as much help as we can get.
Come on, Ben!
Seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me.
Sort of clues we're supposed to be looking for here.
The world is full of obvious things.
All right, guys, that is it for Rebel One. Man, Jeff, this behind us is amazing.
Incredible.
So cool.
I thought you set the bar last year, but you definitely broke it with the show that you have this year. So make sure you stop by Baird Manor. We have got the address right here. We'll do some post magic right there. Come by.
Also, where can people find you?
So you can find me on Baird Manor on any of the social media channels, or jollyholidayshows.com.
And you actually do this for other people too.
Yeah, we can put this on your house.
Awesome.
Well,
links in the description below.
Yes. So again, thank you. It's Josh, Brock, Jacob, and Jeff signing out on Rebel One.